If you prefer your museums with a healthy breeze and grass under your feet, this is one for you. The Edo-Tokyo Open Air Architectural Museum is a collection of buildings spanning the centuries, from thatched farmhouses to modernist suburban homes. Moved and reconstructed from sites across Tokyo, most buildings are from the Meiji period, 1868 to 1912, or later, including an elegant home of a former politician, a public bathhouse, a stationery shop, forms of public transport, and even a police box. Known in Japanese as the Edo-Tokyo Tatemono-en, this museum is a branch of the Edo-Tokyo Museum located in Ryogoku. The name of the museum might be a little misleading. Yes, it is a museum of architecture, so those inclined will have a great time observing up close how the Japanese constructed the thick thatched roofs, called kayabuki, in their minka, or non-samurai, people homes in the mid-1700s, or how they incorporated Art Deco elements in the late Taisho to early Showa period, the Japanese version of the Roaring Twenties. However, this isn't a geeks-only zone for those with an architecture degree. The buildings reconstructed in the museum are filled with objects, from furniture to everyday items of their time. In the stationery shop, the displays are filled with brushes and inkstones. In the bar, there are yakitori skewers and beers on the table. On the walls of the grocery store, there are ads for canned goods and beer. In the farmhouses, there are straw raincoats hanging by the door. And lastly, there are offerings on the Kamadana Shinto altars. Things are so realistic that they can feel somewhat eerie at times, as if the people who lived there just went away and left their lives behind. They aren't actual abandoned structures, but depending on the hour you visit and how thin the crowd is, they might feel that way. These buildings are snapshots of 3 centuries worth of life before modern-day Tokyo. What makes it exceptional though is that these are snapshots you can walk into and around. And if you know your history, or consult the plaques in front of the buildings, you will enjoy the small details. For example, the sewer pipes have been left in the backyard, because children used them as jungle gyms back in the 1960s, when there weren't any video games and play meant simpler equipment and more imagination. From 1913 to 1915, Tonogayato Garden was created as part of the grounds for a residence for the vice president of the Manchurian Railway, Eguchi Teijo. It was designed and built by a landscape gardening organization located in Akasaka called Sengoku. In 1929, it was purchased by the founder of Mitsubishi, Iwasaki Itaro. Based on a design created by Tsuda Saku, a main residence building and tea ceremony building, Kouyou-tei, were added and a combination Western and Japanese-style strolling garden with trees and ponds was completed. In 1974, until this garden was purchased by the city of Tokyo, the Iwasaki family used the buildings and grounds as their residence. The garden is located on the southern edge of the Kokubunji rift line. The natural flora in the Musashi plateau and the cliff-like rift area are well protected. Thus, it is possible to observe many kinds of wild grasses, insects, etc., that have been living in this area since former times. In the Jiro Benten Pond in the garden, there is a depression that contains a natural spring that provides large quantities of fresh water. Water that runs off the cliff collects in this area and is part of the source of the Nogawa River. As can be seen from above, this garden has features that differ from the other gardens in the Tokyo area. The historic site of Musashikoganei Temple is located atop the Musashino Plateau. In 741, Emperor Shimmu issued a decree for the construction of a state-supported temple. Through previous excavations, it had become clear that the area of the temple and the surrounding settlement supporting it extended over an area of 3 square kilometers. Musashi was a large province comprised of 21 districts, and on roof tiles produced for the temple are characters for the names of 20 districts. From this, the involvement of the entire province can be discerned in the construction of the temple, which was built as a particularly large-scale example among all provincial temples throughout the nation. In the Shoku Nihon Keikei Chronicle, there is a record of the Saki no Obasuma district supervisor requesting and receiving permission in 845 to rebuild the 7-story pagoda at Musashikokubunji, which had been struck by lightning and lost to fire. Recent excavations have revealed the location and details of several of the principal structures, including 2 pagodas, unusual for Japanese temples.